And we are back. I am BaronJ67.
I'm T Jones. What's going on? Episode 4.
I know, it's freaking crazy, episode man.
40, man. Welcome to the Adventures of the Black Nerd.
Adventures of the Black Nerd.
We're back, man. First of all, I'd like to shout you out, dog. You've been grinding, man.
Man, I've been out here cracking the whip. Man, bro. I didn't realize how many videos I had put up, but bro,
you've been on the grind, man. I've been keeping up with you, man. I can barely keep up with you,
man.
Oh, sorry for my messy room. It's been like this for a while. It's probably gonna be like that for a while. My wife gave me in the room and was like, "Boy, you need to do something about your room." And then she gonna look at, because I was doing some editing. She gonna look at your room and say, "Your room don't look like that." I'm like, "Man, get out of my space!"
Like, mind your business. Get out of here.
Said, get out of my space, man.
See what? But, what you should have told her is, his wife put all that up.
I should have said that too.
Like, people are like, "Oh, your room's awesome." Like, yeah, my wife is too, man. Because I don't have the knack. Nor, if it was up to me, it would look crazy as hell.
Yeah,
I think it looks pretty cool, and you could probably tell what I put up because it's probably crooked.
anything that ain't straight.
Yeah, anything that ain't straight. I did it. I was like, I can do it. I'm all like a little 2 year old. I got it. I'm a grown man. I can do it. It don't come out right. Nah, it's so bad, man. Like, I try to explain to people when it comes to the like handy stuff, I'm not the one. People are like, "Oh man, the way you painted that wall." I was like, I didn't paint it.
I ain't paint that damn wall.
Yeah. Like,
it wasn't me.
It was not me. "Oh man, how'd you get those plants to grow?" That was my wife. Ask her. She's Dr. Green Thumb. She makes it all happen. Like, it's pretty funny. I'm actually really proud of it. It's something I'm proud of her, and it's really dope. But enough about that. I was getting sappy. So I got to talk about the new hobby I picked up, which is not new because I've been reading and listening to audiobooks for a while now.
Uh-huh.
But
I... Oh, man. What happened? Your audio sounds distorted.
Do I sound...
You sound just like that. Like, you just made it 2 times worse by saying it like that. New hobby.
Okay, so my new hobby. So I almost want you to put all that editing in. I almost don't want you to take nothing out. So
but, I probably won't.
Yeah,
I probably won't.
Yeah, because I think that's gonna be greatness. So with my new hobby, it's not new though. But whatever. I found this new genre of books, which it's new to me. It's everybody probably already know about it.
We've had this conversation on here before.
Yeah, LitRPGs.
Oh, no, not about the book. My bad. About audiobooks.
Yeah, no. Audiobooks.
Don't knock it. Don't knock it till you try it, dog.
I used to talk mad crap like, because I'm an old man. Like, "Oh, you ain't reading. You ain't really there. Whatever. So.
Thank you from Kellogg.
You stupid. What'd you win? Free box of cereal?
Nah, he gave me some Kellogg points.
Oh. Give me some Go-Gurts. Get some free Go-Gurts. Hey, but look, so I'm
all right, my bad.
So I'm hooked on this genre called lit RPGs. Long story short, all they are is somebody living the life of an MMO. And it's not like Lord of the Rings fantasy. It's literally somebody in a world that revolves around MMO mechanics. So the book I'm reading is the System Apocalypse series. And there's like level areas. Whenever he kills monsters, he has to loot the bodies. He ranks up, he has to put his skill points, and randomly throughout the books, he'll check his skills, and it'll be like John Lee, Atrian Warrior, skill points and wisdom 64. So it basically feels like I'm watching or I'm listening to somebody play a whole RPG adventure, and it is another way for me to practice my nerdism. And I love it. Do you
find yourself questioning his decisions?
Yes. And it makes me so mad. Like, so there was a moment where he had to choose where to put his stats. And he went and bought a spell instead of boosting his speed stat. And I was hot. I was like, why wouldn't you boost your speed so you can get more damage, more DPS? And he couldn't figure out if he was tanking or if he was like a hybrid class. Like, it was really, I'm just sitting there, I'm like, you're just dumb.
You're really dumb. See, I find myself, when I watch people on Twitch, I find myself doing the same thing. But the only difference between this, you reading those audio or listening to those audio books and Twitch is I can type to these folks. Hey, man, why would you do that? Make that decision or put question people on the things that they do? Because I do it all the time.
Bro, So I'm sitting here. I'm hooked. I literally picked up. I'm on my fourth book in the series. This is the last one. The new one hasn't came out yet. But this is four books. It'll be four books in 4 days. I'm going to finish this next book tomorrow. Like, if we weren't recording, recording right now, I'd be listening to it.
And all then, right, cut.
Oh, no, just playing. Oh, wait, what happened?
He said, oh, shit, what happened? Like, what?
Cut. Cut.
Nah, because you said if you were going to cut.
If
we weren't recording, you'd be reading it.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, bro. I want some ice cream. I'm not going to lie. That's what I've been thinking about. I've been thinking about some ice cream.
Man, ice cream. Did I ever tell you what happened about me looking for vanilla ice cream on the day of Thanksgiving?
No.
Okay.
You never go shopping on the day of Thanksgiving.
But no, but that's not the issue. The issue is there was no vanilla ice cream. No.
On Thanksgiving.
Like, I've never seen...
Who's open on Thanksgiving?
Walmart, of course. Come on now. But I've never seen nothing like that. It was like post-apocalyptic ice cream section. Rolls empty. I was like, only reason we found some vanilla ice cream was because it was hidden behind something else. And you know it was old because it had like the icicles on it.
Oh, like, hell no.
Like, but of course we took it. Nah, we took it.
this is all we got, though.
Yeah, like,
if you want that peach cobbler, it's all we got.
And you know it was for peach cobbler.
Of course.
And then you know, my mom's got mad at me because I forgot the ice cream. Like, she looked at me like I was crazy. And I was like, Mom, I go to the store. And I'm like, fine.
Find it.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Be that guy to ruin Thanksgiving because you forgot.
Like, oh, everybody throwing their forks at me.
That sounds like a movie.
It really does.
Shame.
Everybody throwing their forks.
Can you imagine walking that hallway out your mom's house? Boo. They just throw stuff.
What movie was that? Somebody boo this man. Boo.
Imagine you ruined Thanksgiving because you forgot the vanilla ice cream.
Oh my god.
You gotta do that walk of shame to the front door.
Nobody want cookie dough with their peach cobbler. Get that shit out of here. Hey, you know my family ruthless. They clown me.
Yeah.
With your old can't spell ass. Like, wait, how am I spelling getting involved? I just forgot the ice cream. Bro, for those who don't know, I grew up in a family where if something bad happened to you,
everybody roasted you
getting clowned, and then they'll worry about you. But first, you got to go through the old mill where everybody just rip you a new one. And
you out here forgetting ice cream at the stove?
Yeah. What, you ate it? You ain't forgot nothing with your big ass. I already just know. I can hear it.
The carton in the back seat.
Yeah, I can hear it now.
I can hear all of that now, too.
Oh, my God. Smell his breath. Oh, God. Check his pockets. Like, how am I fit ice cream in my pocket? Who can?
He can. Oh, shoot.
Bro, I just know.
Oh, I'm dropping stuff. That's funny. But I don't know how we got on.
I don't know either. Oh, something about ice cream. Oh, you said I'd be talking about, I would be reading or listening to an audiobook, and you would be eating ice cream.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, because I really want some ice cream right now.
Yeah, it's okay, though.
So my wife sent me to the store to get her some, there's these ice cream bars called Fat Boys, right?
Oh, them is fire.
Yeah, and she wanted the cookie and creams one.
They got a cookies and cream bad boy ice cream?
They do. Oh my God. I couldn't find none of them. So I came home with them, you know, them strawberry shortcake ones?
Yes, Lord.
But I came home with the Oreo ones. Boy, she was hot. Boy, she was hot. Well, I didn't see her for like 2 days.
I'm mad at you.
She wanted cookies and ice cream or cookies and cream or whatever.
When
and
you get strawberry shortcake, you get strawberry shortcake.
She didn't want strawberry, so I specifically asked her. She said no, she wants cookies and cream. I said, okay, cool. This ain't got no cookie, they ain't got no cookie and cream tub, they ain't got no cookie and cream, nothing.
So you got the cookie and cream strawberry shortcake crunch.
This is close as it gets. It wasn't no strawberry shortcake. I know it wasn't,
but it was a strawberry shortcake ice cream bar.
It looked like it, but it wasn't it.
But it was the cookies and cream.
What she want me to do, man? I'm only one person. Stater Brothers was closed. Bro, I'm tired. And it's hot. I said, nah, I'm good. I'm just get this. I'll get the doghouse. At least I get to go to sleep.
That, man. Sometimes it's all it takes. I just want to go to sleep.
I just
want to go to sleep. Hey, but no, nah, man.
But yeah, back to your books. We're way off track.
Okay. So RPG, he has a companion. The voice actor is amazing. And then there's going to be 5 books. So after this one, I think the next one is supposed to come out early next year. So I don't know if
he most definitely could do that for the rest of his life, right?
Oh, you can just keep the story going. Cause I'm already, like I said, I'm already 4 books in. So
yeah.
And it's only been like 3 days, I'm going on my 4th day. It's bad, bro. And then, you know, I picked up 2 of the Witcher books. Audio books, so I'm ready for that next.
Do you think they're going to do the show based off the book?
Well, okay, so let's talk about that. I don't think we touched on it.
I'm glad you brought it up.
I'm really nervous about it because they haven't established what the time frame is. Have you seen the makeup test?
No.
Okay. Now, I'm open. I'm not going to sit here and bash something until I see it. I'm going to give it a fair shot. And I'm just excited to see a Witcher TV show. So I'm going to just lay that groundwork. But
yeah,
it's
funny when we remember when we did, if we see a movie or something based off of a game, The Witcher was never one of the
choices. Yeah, we didn't even bring
that's
that
crazy,
up.
Right?
Yeah, that was nuts. And now they're coming out with the Witcher TV show.
They're coming out with a Witcher TV show. That's dope.
Now, and it's Henry Cavill. So it's Superman. Yep. I know him as, what was his name? Theseus. Theseus from The Immortals.
Oh, yeah.
You're was alone, Theseus. Or I think it was Theseus.
Was it Theseus? I don't know.
Correct us in the comments. Let us know.
And I love Greek mythology. Bro. I just don't know today.
That was epic. All the gods came down. He's like, you're alone. I was like, ooh. My bad. Look, I straightened up in the theater. I was like, oh, Zeus, man. Hell, he's Zeus. Like,
dang, oh, what do you do to him?
Oh, damn, this is fool Zeus is tripping. Like, oh, Zeus on one, y'all.
Zeus on some shit today, man.
Give him Snickers, because Zeus is tripping. He ain't even throwing lightning bolts. He down here cracking fireworks. He yelling at people. My God.
Dang, what Theseus do to him today, man?
Damn, Theseus, we told you not to do it.
Theseus should have set his ass down.
Somebody shoved him like, I told you. Look, now Zeus down here putting his wrath.
Now he mad at us. Yeah. What we do to him.
What we do. Rolling with your ass. Messing with you. So, okay. Back to The Witcher. So, the major things that I noticed, he had no scars, and he didn't have his pendant.
Mm-hmm.
But he drank a potion. So the thing about potions when it comes to the Witcher lore, for those who don't know, the potions are meant for Witchers. Like, they would kill, they're poisonous. They're poisonous to Witchers, but they're really poisonous to normal humans. Witchers have gone through a process of getting augments and getting different spells and different surgeries and whatnot to make them more enhanced so the potions have effect on them. So that's kind of the story. So seeing him drink a potion but not have any scars or not have his pendant, what I'm hoping is this is during his time training to be the Witcher he became. So if this is a prequel,
prequel.
If this is a prequel or if this is just an early time in his life, which is prequel, I'm okay with that. I'm more than fine. But
I'm cool with that for new things like this because there is no like flashback. Like it's current.
It's
current. I mean, not saying that they won't have flashbacks in it, but to start off current means you have okay from now story. All the way up until the end. You know what I'm saying?
And this is the cool thing too, because speaking on the audiobooks that I picked up, one of the books I got is earlier stories from before the video games. And before the book series, it's so just a bunch of tales of his adventures. So
his adventures, does he have his scar? Does he have his stuff?
Well, I haven't read it yet.
So, oh, okay,
but I'm just trying to make the comparison. So I don't know which world they're going to follow.
They could. It could be before that time. You know what I'm saying? And it could be based off the book. I mean, the legwork is done. Yes. Why reinvent the wheel?
You really don't have to.
That's what, man, I'm telling you, this is what I talk about with like games. When you create a great game, a dope game, you have, and people actually not only enjoy it, but it sells great and things like that, that you have you can go so many different avenues with that. You can create books, you can create comics, you can create things of this nature, and it is kind of reselling what you've already sold, but at the same time you can monetize the hell out of it from super fans and from fans of the games, especially if it's dope collectibles like comic books and things like that. I'm always a fan of that because you don't have to get it if you don't want to.
True.
But as like a fan, I mean, as people we go to, think about it, you go to conventions and buy shit that you already know of. It's the same concept. You see what I'm saying? The only difference is this is direct.
And you know what? Video games are really starting to do that. I think of Bloodborne. Bloodborne came out with comics.
Destiny has comics now.
Destiny has comics. Yep. Who else? Honestly, all major titles out there, and it goes back to the beginning. You go back to like Legend of Zelda and Super Mario Brothers. They had cartoons and comic mm-hmm. books.
Yeah.
I almost bought the graphic novel. They had it at FYE. For those who don't know, 4-Year Entertainment, FYE. It's kind of an extinct store. I only know of a few of them,
but I only know one.
Yeah, yeah.
Shoot.
But no, man. These audiobooks, lit RPGs. If you guys want to get a dose of nerddom on the go, and I would recommend it for people who love RPGs because it'll throw you off when you hear all of a sudden, oh, let me check my stats. And then the guy changes his voice and it gets all mechanical. So, da-da-da-da-da, his mm-hmm. wisdom, his charisma, blah, 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 skill this, skill that. And they go through his whole skill list. But see, mm-hmm. for me, the fact that from the beginning, from the first book to the fourth book, I can go through and write down all his stats and show the change in which each level up, how much he got. And like the fact that I know where he's at, that's dope to me. But that also falls into my love for RPG games.
Yeah, so, in a sense, you get to see this dude play. What's the difference between this and Twitch other than not being able to communicate with him? See what I'm saying? Yeah, it's not. And because, it. you can't see it.
Yeah.
Right?
You got to imagine.
Other than not being maybe able to see it, other than if you're imagining it, some people would say crazy, but you're not imagining you using your imagination to see it and not being able to re-communicate or to communicate with the person on the other side of that or the book, behind the book. What's the difference? We watch people play RPGs all day. They still make the decision. Granted, there's some games out there that the chat can control the game and mm-hmm. things like that. And sometimes some people will base their decisions based off what the majority of their chat is saying. So you get, what's the difference? There is no difference. You know what I'm saying? Other than those two things, there isn't. You're watching somebody play a video game or you're reading someone playing a video game. No difference. Facts.
Man, it's so dope. I recommend it to anybody, any fan of RPG. Now, moving on to something.
Ooh, video game award.
There you
go.
Is
that where we're going?
That's where we're going. So, Salad. Yeah, run it.
So, all right. So, I think the first category for 2018 was Game of the Year.
Yes.
And the nominees are.
Now, this is the Game Awards. December. I want to say it's like December 6th or December 8th
this year. December 6th.
Okay, December 6th. We're just going to read off a few categories. We're not going to go through all of them.
Yeah, we're not going to go through them all. I mean, some of them are questionable. I'm going to just talk about questionable. Like, Game of the Year.
Yes.
Well, Game of the Year is obviously the big one. Nominees are Assassin's Creed Odyssey. How do you say this one?
Celeste.
Celeste, God of War, Marvel's Spider-Man, Monster Hunter, and Red Dead Redemption. Now, Red Dead shouldn't be on there. I don't know how it got on there. 100%. It should not be on there. 100%. Assassin's Creed Odyssey just came out.
Yeah.
Month ago, right?
Yeah, it's probably been out like 4 or 5 weeks longer than Red Dead. So it's kind of an iffy one, too.
Marvel's Spider-Man came out like 2 months ago, I want to say.
September? I want to say it was either August or September.
Okay. So, and then Monster Hunter. Now, granted, I would say out of all of these games, what would be your choice?
Okay. My choice, well, see, this is what's so bad about it. I call myself a gamer, but I haven't played Assassin's Creed Odyssey. I probably will never
play one Assassin's Creed, you play them all.
No, you can't say that with this one. Because I was thinking that with Origins, but I heard Origins was very different. That was dope. That was a revamping of the system. I heard this is a revamp of Origins. So this is a completely different game from the way everybody talks about it. So I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Celeste, I'm probably not going to play. It looked like a Metroidvania-esque game. I don't know much about it, so I don't want to butcher it. I don't want to knock it, but I just, it doesn't pique my interest.
Exactly.
God of War, I did play. Marvel Spider-Man, I have yet to play yet. I have yet to play yet. Wow, that was terrible. Monster Hunter World, I got easily 200 hours in. Red Dead Redemption, I probably have like 30, 35 hours in. So,
like I said, Red Dead shouldn't be on there because the full game ain't out
even
out. Yet.
We haven't even experienced the online aspect of it.
That's not even a choice. But
for me,
I would
go ahead.
Well, you didn't even make your choice.
No, I didn't make my choice. So, based on my limited description, I would have to say Monster Hunter World. Now, this is why. As much as I love God of War, I gotta call it out. The enemies were all the same height. There was only few variation in the enemies. The trolls were all the same. And it had a lot of the same mini games and puzzles. So it didn't, at some point I felt like I was watching a movie and playing along to it instead of playing a game that had a great story. So I felt like it would have been a better movie. I'm not knocking it because I played it and I had fun. But when you really look at the core of it, the diversity of the enemies was not there. So I guess that's why I say Monster Hunter World.
I would say Monster Hunter World as well, but I'm going to say not because of the only two choices, if you ask me, is God of War or Monster Hunter. Like, it comes down to those. I choose Monster Hunter because Monster Hunter was complete, as in it. And then a Monster Hunter has adapted like the Destiny S and other. And Destiny wasn't the first name. Destiny game I play, so I'm gonna use that as in the whole weekly reset, the seasons, things like that with inside the games where things come back for you to go and chase. And it can go away for some time. So time-gated material. Granted, some people don't like it, but it also makes you say, oh, well, I got to play Monster Hunter. Not only because I want to reach this goal, because I'm pretty sure when you're speaking to me and you, you at least can walk away from a game easy.
No problem.
Right?
No
you problem. Have more hours in my... Hell, I got Monster Hunter downloaded on my game, and I think I've only turned it on like twice. So you've played Monster Hunter more than me, but I have watched a lot of Monster Hunter. I have, I can say that I think that Monster Hunter should win over God of War, the reason why I say over, reason why, and I thought God of War was a great game.
Yeah.
Just like you were saying, it was a good movie. Remember, we talked about this. Mm-hmm. God of War would have been a great movie, but because, not because this God of War would have been a great movie. Always. Any of the God of Wars would have been, Wars would have been a great movie. I'm for the reasons of the boss, it be the, you know, the things being the same. I'm not sure if that would be like a concern for me, because that's God of War. That's the title. It's always been like that, except for like the bosses and stuff. The puzzles in previous God of War games, I think, were a lot harder. I think this game did a lot. They tried to make it like free world PvE, mm-hmm. you know, all over the place. Like you can revisit places, whereas in God of War, previous God of Wars, yeah, you just, it was just a, exactly straight shot. So this God of War, I don't think captivated. I think it had its time and then it went away. Whereas Monster Hunter is still here. Monster Hunter is still being played. People are still chasing stuff. People are still looking for stuff. People are still catching monsters. So I would have to give it to Monster Hunter's World. I don't think that.
And it's a worldwide game.
Exactly.
Monster Hunter World, not just because of the title, but it's something that's played all over the world. I wonder if you looked at God of War numbers, how successful it was around the world. Like, it might just be successful as a Western game, while Monster Hunter is successful.
That's a good point. I would wonder that.
It just, you know, Monster Hunter World reaches more of the Earth than, in my opinion, God of War would.
Yeah. I mean, who doesn't like catching monsters?
Bro. And then the variety of the monsters, the different movements. It's not just, of course they do have reskins. I'm not going to sit here and act like they don't. But the amount of reskins in comparison to what I experienced in God of War is very, very low.
Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, well, that's the nature of it.
Yeah, I'm not knocking it.
Go ahead.
I'm not knocking it, but if I had to, once again, if I had to pick Game of the Year, I would pick Monster Hunter World over God of War.
Now, it actually said, it says so Game of the Year, the title of it is absolute best experience across all creative and technical fields. Monster Hunter World.
Yeah, that so answers the question.
Now, that answers it.
Now, from what I've heard, now excluding timeline, let's take out time frame. I've heard a lot of great things about Assassin's Creed, but I can't speak to it because I have not played it. Mm-hmm. But
I've heard, go ahead.
Red Dead Redemption, speaking on that, in the short time frame that has been out, I'm enjoying the living hell out of that game.
Of course.
I've done all type of craziness. I have yet to get bored. I'm still only in chapter 2, and it's not because it's too hard or anything like that, but I'm just having so much fun running around hunting.
Yeah. See, I think that these awards should be done like more, it should be more structured, because it's not giving these games a fair shot. You know what I'm saying? These games like Red Dead, regardless of how good Red Dead is to both of us, it's still incomplete.
It is.
We still have stuff that
there's a whole half of the game missing.
Exactly. A whole other aspect of the game that we haven't even touched. So regardless of that, how could this game win? You see what I'm saying? I couldn't see it winning. But what I was saying is, I don't think these awards do these games justice by doing it the way they're doing it, because putting these fairly new games in the running when clearly they should probably be for next year
next year,
or they should do it like a 2-year gate, two times a year type deal. You see what I'm saying? Because when you do it like that, you give everybody a fair shot to win.
I think an easier way of what you're saying would be to run it the fiscal calendar. So anything
October
to September, that would be that year's game awards. Because that makes more sense. Because then next year would be Red Dead Redemption, Assassin's Creed. They wouldn't even be on this list.
Yeah.
They would be on next year's list, and it would make more sense.
And then it was so, I mean, it was so many other.
Yeah.
Did Fortnite win a game of the year already?
Let me tell you what Fortnite is. And this is a really crappy comparison, but I'm just using it because Kanye brought it up a while back. Remember how Kanye got on stage about Beyonce had the greatest video of all time. Yeah. Well, if you put Fortnite in every category, Fortnite would win.
Yeah, well deserved.
But that's why you don't put Fortnite in every category.
And I'm not even a true Fortnite fan like that.
But it's just common sense. It's way too many people playing it, and it's way too many people enjoying the hell out of it. And
but at least
we vote.
But at least the game of the year. At least game of the year. Like, I could see other categories giving it. I could see saying, all right, can't put it in every category. But the categories that make sense, yes. Because think about it. Think about the other games that's not in here. PUBG had a strong run this year. Nobody's playing it now.
Yeah.
Fortnite, people still playing it. Fortnite has been top five in numbers when you're looking at strictly off of Twitch. Strictly off of Twitch. Not even counting Facebook. Because there's a lot of streamers on Facebook, not even counting other platforms out there, YouTube, Mixer, whatever. Fortnite ain't left top five in viewership off of Twitch. True. See what I'm saying? And it has created so many famous people that have gone, that have not only elevated, Fortnite has helped elevate it, but it has elevated Fortnite as well. So they go hand in hand. Wow. So.
Well, let me.
I sit here and think of that. I'm like, yo, at least game of the year category based off of what you said.
Let me tell you the only reason I would say no. Only reason is because games as a service, most of these games wouldn't make the list because they'd be trumped by those. You'd be trumped by your Warcrafts. You'd be trumped by your. You'd be trumped by Fortnite. You'd be trumped by Destiny. You know what I mean? Just because of the sheer amount of people who religiously play these games and how at any given moment Iron Banner will pop up and now everybody and their mom is playing that. And you know what I mean? It just, the info.
I hear what you're saying, but
I only say
that because of that.
Yeah. Like, and Fortnite is something special. I'm diminishing it. Cause even in comparing it to Destiny 2's numbers, even though Destiny 2 is good, here's Destiny 2. Here's Fortnite and sheer
Fortnite,
in terms of numbers. No, you know what I mean? So I'm diminishing it. So I get what you're saying, but who knows how long it would be before Fortnite gets off the game of the year category. Like, where do we draw it?
I feel like at least it should be once. Like, I don't think it should go, because there's so many other games that comes out. I mean, look at the volume of games that come out every day.
True.
They got so many games coming out. They're giving out free games, giving them out. See what I'm saying? So something's gonna stick. Now, if nothing sticks, who's to blame for that?
Mm.
See what I'm saying? Who's to blame for creative minds? And then let's continue to use Fortnite. Fortnite runs the board, right?
Mm-hmm.
They run the board. They're making Fortnite. Fortnite's doing its thing. Continue putting up updates, blah, 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 blah. Same argument you made against Rockstar and Grand Theft Auto 5. You're going to just stick to Fortnite? Like, you're going to stick to Fortnite? Well, you're not going to do anything new? Because now the same game is winning. So who's to blame for that? The developers, obviously.
But let me tell you, though, Fortnite started on that platform.
Of what?
Well, no, let me rephrase. Fortnite, after Battle Royale blew up, they left the other game behind. And they went to Battle Royale. So,
yeah.
But because you used the comparison of the whole Grand Theft Auto Rockstar.
Yeah.
I don't expect Fortnite to do anything but add new skins and new emotes. I truly don't. Add maybe a new map eventually. But,
yeah, of course.
But I don't expect change from
them. Not even a new map. I know we don't play Fortnite as much, but the way that they doing that game, it makes me wonder why a lot of developers don't say, fuck it, let's just do what they doing when it comes to how they're rolling out content, because they messed around and messed up the whole map, created all new areas on the map, took out pieces, put in new pieces, moved things around. And obviously people who play it on a daily basis know where these new changes have been made mm-hmm. and where they are, but that's how they're going about their game. And it's something new. So I do understand what you're saying about the sheer force that Fortnite would wreak upon other games coming out in the field. But I just feel like they're always trying to raise the bar. Mm-hmm. New games are always trying to raise the bar. They're always trying to do it. Look at games like Anthem. Look at Division. Division was called the Destiny Killer. Mm-hmm. It was called the Destiny Killer. This is what Destiny should be. Until
update 1.01.
And then and then even after recovering, it still didn't hit that point.
No.
So I think a lot of people, if a lot of people back their games, I would consider it the rollout because there's some dope games out here that nobody plays. I know if I played it, I would enjoy it. Oh, you see what I'm saying? It's just everything is overshadowed by your Destinies, your Red Deads, because they're AAA titles. So,
like, I'm going to be honest. I'm actually, and I know we've talked about this before, and we'll get back to the game awards, folks. So we're just having a small little tangent.
I'm sorry, you've been here 40 episodes. This is how we do.
This is just how we
never
do.
Yeah. it never goes as
structure
planned.
Is weak. but my point is, a concern of mine is if this is what the masses are okay with, the cell phone game model brought to console and PC,
mm-hmm.
where are we heading? As a whole, like what happens to the generation of kids who grow up on Fortnite when they get our age? What games are they looking forward to? You know what I mean? Like what?
Oh, no.
Like that's these. Do you know what I mean? Like us? Yeah. We dab. Like I'm not saying kids don't play a bunch of different games, but most kids I know, when they say what do, when they talk about video games, they're like, "Do you play Fortnite?" It's always Fortnite. It's no other game. No, like me, I look at my child, because I got my childhood game right here. I'm looking at my Nintendo 64, and I got a tactical game called Ogre Battle 64. You know, I know I'm an outlier when it comes to my game choice, but I also have my 007. I have my Golden Eye. I had my Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles on Super Nintendo. Oh. You know what I mean? I've had the range. Command and Conquer, blah, 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 Age of Empires. But when all I hear from all these kids is, Fortnite.
Because it's just like I said, it's the way this stuff is being rolled out. I think it's not just Epic Games, because Epic Games ran with the model that PUBG was doing. Oh yeah, the game is early access.
Yeah,
it's everybody seeing the potential in Fortnite. Samsung.
Yeah.
Red Bull.
Yeah,
everybody sees the potential in it. Bro, everybody sees the numbers that they can make from it, and decided, "Hey, let's jump on this wagon until the wheel fall off." I ain't knocking it.
No, I can't knock it at all. I can't knock the hustle. I'll never knock the hustle. Get your money, man. But we have to discuss and prep for the residual effects.
Mm-hmm.
This just like how I'll be shocked if we get some major DLC for Red Dead Redemption, because what I think is going to happen, all DLC is going to be online content.
It is. Yeah, of course.
But think about that. Rockstar used to have some of the best DLCs for Grand Theft Auto. Grand Theft Auto 4 had some of the best extra storylines.
Yes.
You had, what was it, Ballad of Gay Tony. What were they called? The Lost, the motorcycle gang.
I know what you're talking about.
And then there was another one. You had some of the best full-blown stories, full-blown. It was like a whole nother game. Remember with the biker gang, you got to call your crew. They would ride with you. That you'd call the truck, and it'd be a mobile gun shop. It was just a whole new world.
I'm I'm gonna tell you though, with I see where you're going with that, but I'm gonna tell you the reason why that made sense for Grand Theft Auto then. Grand Theft Auto Online wasn't as popular as Grand Theft Auto, the storyline and everything you can do inside of the main mission of the game. True. I think what Grand Theft Auto decided to do was they give you the same world, but RPG form, where you create this character. Shoot, this man. Character is a resemblance of you. You make the decisions for the characters, blah, 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 blah. And they decided, hey, let's just give it to that because you've already beat this. Why have to go back and do that when you're already trying to progress your character here? Let's give it to you in this form. You see what I'm saying? That's what they did with Grand Theft Auto 5. Grand Theft Auto 5. Because you're right. With Grand Theft Auto 4, all of those DLCs were dope. But remember, that was like the era of, that was like the beginning, almost like the cusp, the beginning of DLC era, Call of Duty rollout every 3 months, a new DLC type deal. And Grand Theft Auto did it, and those were amazing to us. A lot of people couldn't even tell you what happened in those missions. You see what I'm saying? Sure. So I think with that, when you use Grand Theft Auto 4 in that way, you can specifically see why they did it, because at that time it was the best thing to do. People would go back and do those missions and play that part of the game rather, because there was no progression system for an online character that they could create.
100%. But all that does is further add to my worry. It made sense for that time. So of course, what's gonna happen? Do you get what I'm saying? Like I get
what you're saying, but okay. I don't think the online era is going anywhere. No.
Oh no, it's not. It's only gonna shoot forward.
Because look at all the DLCs that people buy for.
Yeah.
It's like crazy. The internet EMP go off and internet down for four. Let's use PlayStation as an example. PlayStation gets hacked and their network is down for 3 months. And you bought all your DLCs for this game that you love, but it's online only.
Gee, and now you're talking.
Now you back to playing. Now you back to playing Tetris. Now you back to playing Candy Crush on your phone.
You speak my language. That's my fear with dumping everything into the online experience, mm-hmm. or making your game only function if you have online experience, like games as a service. My fear with Fallout 76, my worry with, you know, I can go on and on and on, but
of course,
but I'm not an old head. I'm not mm-hmm. completely against the
future. Of course not.
I pray, you don't understand. My wife will tell you, I pray religiously that I live long enough to experience a high level of full dive technology, mm-hmm. like where I can throw on my headset, hit start, and I'm gone. Like, and I'm in a whole nother world playing a game, running around. I hope, as I look at my Sword Art Online pop figures, Kirito and Asuna, I pray I live long enough to experience that.
Of course.
I don't think we're that far from it.
No.
People are already taking digital vacations. Have you seen like the commercials for the Vive?
No, I have not.
They got some dope commercials where you just watch people live out their lives, and then all of a sudden the person takes their headset off. And the mm-hmm. HTC, I was like, oh, damn. Like, it just, I know we're getting closer closer to that. I honestly think we're like 20 years out. I really do. I feel that.
I think we're close. I'm all hip for it, but I still think, with everything being so online is fast. True. Online is instant. Instantly, I can send a message here. True. Or instantly, I can deliver this here via online. And with online being so strong and being so the amount of not control, but with online being what it is today, it's not going anywhere.
No, it's not.
Because of that fact. Because of the fact of, you know, within the online experience, you can enjoy it with your friends. True. You know, we talk about the era of, oh, yeah, you used to go to somebody's house, sit next to them in a split screen. I will never play split screen ever again.
Bro, I'm like, wait, I gotta give up some of my screen?
If you ain't got your own TV, own Ethernet cable, I'm not playing with you.
Get out of here. Go home.
So as we say this, why, you know, we have to understand that, yo, online is the route. Like, imagine, let's go back to Grand Theft Auto 4. Imagine having the option to play one of the, you know, a great addition to the story mode of the game, right? But you're in this, you've created this online character that's at level 3. And you're trying to get leveled up because you want this gun. And you want to unlock this. And you want to do this. You need to build up your stamina. Motherfuckers ain't going to be so pressed to go play this story mode where the only thing they get out of it is the story mode.
Got you.
I'm trying to level my character up so I can be beastie, bulky. I can carry 8 guns and do all of this crazy stuff. I can slide, jump, shoot, and drive all at the same time.
Right.
You know, that's the era we live in. This is why people on Fortnite, hey, I got to do my challenges so I can unlock my skins. They got skins on the account that they never touched before. Yep. But I want to unlock it, though.
Yep. 100%.
You know what I'm saying? People are so pressed to do the online activities, and I have fell victim to it too. You see how you use Destiny as an example with Iron Banner? Oh shit, Iron Banner! Don't talk to me about nothing else. Iron Banner is here. I gotta do my bounties. I gotta make sure complete. Look, perfect. Let me use another Destiny example. Destiny's new DLC will be dropping December, right?
Damn, already? Keep going.
The Black Armory. I won't go too far into it, but it's called Black Armory, new DLC, December, first week in December, right? Bang. It's preparation time. Every time a new DLC comes out for Destiny, it's prep time. I got to do my bounties. Don't turn it in. Save it. Because if you save your bounties, you can instantly level up, shoot up to the next level because you turn them all in, and then you use your damn medallion so you get 10% XP boost. Like, that's prep shit. Like... This is how they get you. This is how I've been got. I've been caught like that. I've been, oh yeah, I got to do the raid because I need this gun I can go all day with the online experience. The online experience has it's a monster, and it's just nowhere. It's not going nowhere. No.
Now speaking on that, so let's keep on with the game awards because I know we're kind of off topic. Rolling with that. Best ongoing game awarded to the game for outstanding development of ongoing content that evolves the player experience over time. First up, we have Destiny 2, Forsaken. Next, we have Fortnite. Then we have No Man's Sky. Then we got Overwatch. And then we have Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege. Who do you pick?
Fortnite.
That's the smart.
It has to be Fortnite.
Now, I'm going to go ahead.
Everything you just read is Fortnite. Fortnite.
But I'm going to tell you, though... Just to be devil's advocate, I would pick No Man's Sky. Only because it went from a game that was complete trash that nobody wanted to touch with a 10-foot pole to they completely gave you a whole new... Or they finally gave you the game they promised. Or at least a very close estimate to it.
And yeah, but if you say that... If you say that, then you're going to have to agree with Destiny as well.
Well, yeah, of course.
And then you're going to have to agree with Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege as well.
But, of course, they
start off rough, and then they have the second chance to rebuttal.
Let me tell you, there's a big difference between starting off rough and just completely lying and not giving you anything promised. So, Destiny still at its core.
With Destiny 2, they were as open as possible. They had everybody come out.
Yep.
All the YouTubers. Uh-huh. If we was lied by motherfuckers, it was YouTube and the fanboys that went out and played the game beforehand. Facts. So they gave us everything that we asked for. It's just people not being very honest and forthcoming with information or with information to them to better the game. But I get what you're saying because yes, the redemption. Just like The Division, the redemption. The listening to the community. And out of all of these developers on here, I think the one that does it the best is Bungie. Listening to the community, talking, giving feedback, not only giving feedback, but receiving feedback, and then go ahead and giving people what they want. is Bungie, but that's not what the category is. Best ongoing game, hands down, Fortnite. It answers everything that you said.
There you go. So now, what was the next one I wanted to go over?
Damn, you're going back to the robotic. I don't know. It's robotic. Yeah.
Oh, that's trash.
Oh my gosh, this is horrible.
Well, just use my recording because you sound fine. Let me see. So, best esports game. All right.
Best esport?
For the game that has delivered the best overall esports experience to players.
Damn, you jumped. Where?
Well, yeah. Oh, that's way down here. I went to category list.
Yeah, that's where I'm at.
Yeah. Click on it. So, best esports. Now I got to start over. For the game that has delivered best overall esports experience to players, inclusive of tournaments, community support, and content updates, irrespective of genre or platform. So we have CSGO, Dota 2, Fortnite, League of Legends, Overwatch. I would have to say it's between Fortnite and League of Legends.
Not Fortnite. It has to be League of Legends.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you why. Fortnite, it wasn't Epic Games that created it. It was the Friday Showdown thing that was created by the community. Mm-hmm. And they decided, hey, it's about time for us to dab in the competitive scene. And that idea wasn't theirs. The competitive side to Fortnite is a great thing. I think it's dope. I don't think it's as captivating as League of Legends.
They
go all out for their community. When I say they go all out, I mean, I'm talking about no regulations. What do you call them? Like when somebody owns a team,
no management.
No, like they have spots just like the NBA.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's just like that with League of Legends. Ooh. Community support. And I think, I don't know if Dota has the same thing, but I know League for a fact has it.
Is huge.
Community support is out through the roof.
Bro, the meta wave is consistently changing with League of Legends. And have you seen like Reddit posts from people in League of Legends? Like, oh my God, this character is now trash.
Yeah.
But no, I can't believe I completely disrespected Overwatch because I love the Overwatch League.
I think
Overwatch, Team Los Angeles.
Yeah, sorry. You're right. Overwatch is just like League. They have it. But I think Overwatch they started off at a rocky standpoint where a lot of people in the community didn't like the route that the developer was taking with the game. So when people caught on to it, it wasn't not late, but it was like, oh, okay, cool. They're doing this. They're doing that. They're buffing this. Mm-hmm. They're nerfing that. They're taking this away. You know, that's when they started becoming, oh, okay, they're finally fixing what we want. And I just don't think, I think League of Legends is still.
League of Legends is bigger, of course. Yeah. Like, I would vote League of Legends hands down. But in my opinion, Overwatch, as in terms of commercial success and commercial leagues, the fact that you got people such as Shaq who own a team, you got people like Rick Fox. Like these people own teams.
Dallas Cowboys.
Yeah. Like
Jerry Jones.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Robert Kraft.
Yes.
It's crazy. So knowing that it's made it to this point, it's wild, man. I love it.
And I'm so, like, I find myself watching more competitive game-related shows and things like that than I do watching sports, real-life sports. And I grew up playing sports. Mm-hmm. The reason being is because a lot of people disrespect esports by saying, oh, yeah, it's not really a sport. It's just a video game. Well, let me see you. Let me see you do this.
Yeah.
Facts. Do what he just did.
Yeah,
and then if you can do what he just did, then you're right. Because this is an art. Like, they really practice. It's so, just like how anybody would say football is as technical as anything else in the world, or soccer is. Listen, these fools count frames and spacing and
all the technical wired controllers.
Jesus,
real people, real hardcore gamers do not do wireless.
Don't do wireless. Nope.
There is a delay that a real competitive person would recognize.
Will feel, exactly.
Man,
I'd be like, I don't be feeling nothing, man.
They do not.
You had to get a cable. I was thinking, like, maybe because with the PlayStation 4, you can't play wired. Mm. It's always Bluetooth. So there's a device that you need to get that you plug your cord in, that you plug your controller in, that takes the Bluetooth factor away.
Wow.
I remember back when, I forget what Call of Duty it was, but people's phones and the Bluetooth on in the arena was messing up.
Yep, I remember
people
that.
People playing the game. So they had to, they made everybody leave the area where they were at, and the teams ended up still losing. That's when the device was created to negate that. Obviously, PlayStation had to do something fast because, yo, y'all supporting one of the biggest console esports in the world right now. Y'all better fix something. Y'all better do something, right? So that's when they came out with the, I believe the device is called the Chronos. But I even heard that's troubled as well. But yeah, man, I would give it to League if you're asking me.
Now, this is something, because I know this is something you're really into. Best fighting game. For the best game designed primarily around head-to-head combat, Blaze Blue Cross Tag.
Dragon. There's no question with this one.
Dragon Ball Z, Fighter Z. Soul Calibur. Street Fighter V Arcade Edition.
You see my reaction, right?
Who is it?
Dragon Ball Fighter Z, or it's Dragon Ball Fighters. But that is the reason. That is the game, the fighting game of the year. No other game came close at Evo. No other game came close at Evo.
See, I knew you would know about this. Go ahead.
You can even jump to, you can put two categories in one. It was best esports player, Sonic Fox.
Hands down.
He was a part of that. Mm. The reason why I give it to him is because he went on to win Evo Dragon Ball Z Fighters, and no other fighter game had the turnout that Dragon Ball Z Fighters had. So there's no question what the best fighting game is. It has to be Dragon Ball Z. Not only is it a good game, because I played it, I enjoyed it. I'm not as heavy into fighting games as I used to, but with the updates that they've put out, with the character nerfs and buffs that they put out, which I didn't agree with the Cell nerf. They nerfed Cell to oblivion. Like, you can't even really use him. So Cell got nerfed. With the nerfs, the buffs that they're doing into the game, with them adding characters into the game and shifting the meta up, it was like, whoa, what did we do? Like, everybody was Goku's dad, and I don't know how to say his name. I'm a butcher. I think it's Samusa, the guy that created Goku Black.
Oh, okay.
He wished himself to be Goku, and he became Goku Black. Anyway, spoiler alert, they put him into the game, and they added so many different characters. They nerfed Gotenks. It was just so much things that they did into the game. So I think Dragon Ball Z, hands down, won that. And then, like I said, coupling that with another category, Esports Player of the Year, Sonic Fox, the guy is who he is, man. The guy is a maniac. I just watched a mini doc on him. I think his perspective as an esports player is dope. I think it's like, yo, you got to prove to me that you're as good to me, because you could talk trash about me all day. If you can't beat me, you know what are we talking about here? And I think that type of swag and confidence in esports, in fighting games, is unmatched by anybody else.
Didn't he beat Uzi? Was it Uzi that he went up against? I could be wrong, but for some reason that sounds familiar.
I'm not sure.
All right, whatever. But no, you're 100% right. Sonic Fox. Then how you just stunt? How you win and then donate the money, like to the loser's family? Like he was like,
he's been a part of so many moments in the fighting game community. It's hard to overlook him.
Mm-hmm. Like He's going down in history. Yeah. Legend. Straight legend.
So Sonic Fox for that one. But
well, we're at our time.
We are at our time. You want to do one more?
Pick a category of your choice. I went through the ones I wanted to.
We can do role-playing, RPG, best RPG.
Oh, okay. So we got Dragon Quest, Monster Hunter, Ni No Kuni, Octopath Traveler, Pillars of Eternity. Now, okay, RPG-wise...
Yeah, you got this one, dog.
Now, the issue is you got JRPGs, and then you have... like isometric RPGs from Obsidian. These are like different levels. I feel like they should have split it. But it's a vague enough term. Okay, RPG. I would say Monster Hunter World gets the most love. Octopath Traveler was something different. It was Nintendo Switch and they made it it was a 3D 2D game. And all those characters you see on the Octopath Traveler, they all have their own story. So you can play, get them all together. So it would be between Monster... I'd say Octopath Traveler just for being something different. For being something completely different. New on the board. Done. I would say Octopath Traveler.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can buy me that for Christmas. All right, so we hit our time. And so... apparently, I sounded like a robot through a lot of this one, and I apologize. If you want to see something funny, go watch the clip, the Stalker episode of the Adventures of Gumball.
Okay.
The Stalker episode where the ice cream stalks her because she makes a song and she sounds like this. But yeah, so. Much love to Tone Deaf Network.
Thank you, sir. I really appreciate it. I will get Messenger back on my phone.
Right? Oh, gosh, man. I know. I'll be like, dang, he just ignoring us.
Yeah, he just ignored everybody.
Meetings and whatnot. And like, where's T. Jones? I don't know. Hiding behind the X.
I'm going to do a whole revamp of my name. The whole revamp. I'm just call me something else, man.
Like, oh, I'm tired of this.
Tired of the X and the T. Jones. It was just dead. Like, I had to pick something. I couldn't put a dot.
Hey, but that just shows how, like, caveman-ish I am because I keep forgetting it's a placeholder. Like, it's a universal placeholder. Everybody knows that.
It is. Yeah. Like, you don't know how many letters they use.
Like...
yeah, like come on, dog. It's like the first letter.
Yeah, like you did everything right, but I just keep butchering it.
It's so funny. I remember when those type of names, this is the last topic. I remember when those type of names became popular back on PlayStation 3. Because remember, people's first name was like Johnny Bravo 45998, whatever. Or like they had like their name, you know, like their nickname.
And then remember it turned into what was it? Lowercase X. Big X, capital X, and then your name, and then the big X.
So I remember the first name I created after that was X Cruelty. It was my second name I created after that. It was my troll name. So it was X because Cruelty was taken.
Of course,
it was X Cruelty because we all had our original OG names. And it was like, come on, man, like, we got to switch it up. So, oh, no, I'm sorry. My first name was not that. My first name was X Ackright.
I do remember that.
It was X Ackright. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God.
That was the name. I'm sorry. And that wasn't even my troll name. You know what I created that name for? Because I was so far in SOCOM confrontation, like, killed to death-wise, I couldn't get to a 2.0. I was stuck forever at a 1.5. And the reason why is because I started the game off horrible, like killing myself or getting into team kill fights and stuff like that. Yeah, doing stupid stuff like that. And I was like, yo, man, I know I can get a 2.0. And I remember creating that name, and that the KD on that account was like a 5 point something. Jeez. And it was a fresh account. So yeah, man, I remember those days. But yeah, it's a placeholder. Universal placeholders. They use Z's. They use O's. Come on now. Get it right.
Okay. So, all right. I'm BaronJ67.
Look how you got all professional.
He's,
like,
he's xTJones.
No. I'm TJones. I'll catch y'all later, man. Peace. All right, Mac Dre.
Rest in peace. Peace.